Welcome back to my project, this is Eric. This is not a smart planner that waters your plants automatically, but something special. Honestly, I know nothing about growing plants. I don't know if I tried it when I was young, but I have no idea about it. So what I thought was to get help from ChatGPT so that people like me can easily grow plants. Here are the friends I need for this project. First, this is a plant pot purchased from IKEA and costs $4. The beginning is feeble, but the end is prosperous.
I hope so.
The first plant I'm going to try is eggplant. I bought this from Amazon. The price is $5.29. It contains between 30 and 50 seeds. I chose this because Google says it is one of the easiest plants to grow. Since this is for outdoor use, I think I will have to replant it in my backyard later. The soil is brought from the backyard. It's just soil. For now, this seems good enough. Let's take a look at the device part. This is the SHT10 soil temperature and humidity sensor. The casing is waterproof and will keep water from seeping into the body of the sensor and damaging it, but allows the air to pass through so they can measure the humidity outside. Humidity readings have 4.5% accuracy, temperature is 0.5 Celsius accuracy. A microcontroller is required to interface. The sensor works with 3 or 5 volt logic and has 4 wires. The following is ESP32S3 device with an e-paper display. The resolution is 540x960 and black and white. The reason for using this was to create a system that runs on battery. That's why I chose an e-paper product that can minimize power consumption. After 1 minute of necessary work, it goes into deep sleep mode. In deep sleep mode, power consumption is drastically reduced, so you can save a lot of battery usage. This is a repo battery for this project. It's a single cell battery and has 1200 mAh. I will display the battery voltage on the screen. That's all I have. Let me plant it from now. All done. Let's see how it works. The screen I made is divided into 3 sections. The first section presents the stored data in tabular form. And the second section displays the data in graph form. And the final section presents the answers obtained from ChatGPT. Let's look at the workflow in more detail. In this program, all data is saved on the SD card, so it does not operate without an SD card. After starting the program, try to connect to Wi-Fi. If it still is not available after 30 seconds, it will go through everything locally. Since there is an RTC IC, if you update a time the first time, you can know the current time without a Wi-Fi connection. Save the temperature and humidity data from the sensor to the SD card along with the local time. After that, the data to draw on the screen is brought from the SD card. You can draw the table and the graph with this data. If you have a Wi-Fi connection, you can ask ChatGPT a question with your current data. I made a question in advance to ask this. All tasks must be completed within 60 seconds of starting the program. After this time, it enters deep sleep mode immediately and wakes up after a set amount of time to repeat the same operation. This is the first plant pot I made that can be helped by ChatGPT. This project source code is shared through the project GitHub page. You can find it in the video description. I hope it will be helpful for your project. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.